The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome, everybody, to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour with me. And whether you're in Catalonia, Estonia, Macedonia, Patagonia, or even Slovenia, we love to come to you at this time every day.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So, well, we're up 4 points in the S&P cash. Dow's, what is that, up 10, 11 points. NASDAQ, of course, a big winner, up 82 points, which is about 0.75%. The other ones, you can make a argument, are flat after being down about 20 points earlier in the S&P cash. They've come out here just a little higher. Again, in the newsletter this morning, you always want a thing in ranges of probability and what's most likely. Most likely from options and everything I'm looking at on Friday tomorrow, we test 3,400, or by tomorrow, we test 3,400 on the S&P cash. That's about an 80% probability. So, and what are we going to call it? 25 points higher than flat coming into the day. The opposite side was a 20% chance that we go down 100 points. So not much of a chance, but of course, fairly asymmetric. My thoughts earlier and even into yesterday were showing that the S&P could go much higher than 3,400. And maybe we still get some kind of news or something that drives us higher tomorrow. But I think from watching the options continue to tighten, that 3,400 area on the S&P cash is kind of where we are looking. Options in stocks like like Apple continue to show that it looks like 380. Let's see what we got for right now. 385 is where options market makers think that we're going to go out. Now, maybe that'll change today, but my guess is at worst it would go down to 375. So we're probably got another $5 to $15 in Apple tomorrow, which makes it very tough to see a NASDAQ go lower. Of course, on any kind of options expiration, 80% of them, you're going to see them close higher than the week ago Wednesday high. And let me just pull those back up to actually say what those are. Where is that? Okay, data, that would be, what would have last Wednesday be? It would have been the 12th. Okay, so you're really looking at 3380. 80% of the time, the market's going to close over 3380 tomorrow, at Friday, at the close. And with about an 80% probability. So it's very tough to see anything coming in. Now, you can always get a surprise, but at the moment, I think we've been surprised out this year. And, you know, even this morning, I think a lot of people probably went short, probably going to see those folks probably cover before the end of the day. So maybe we got another 5 points higher or 10 points higher in the S&P cash. And then, of course, tomorrow, my guess is they'll be right back at it, shorting ad nauseum, but not a lot out there that says anything for a whole lot lower other than some kind of surprise. What can you say? There are a lot of weak sectors. They're all made up for by a handful of stocks like Apple that just keep going higher. So at least on the indexes, they're pretty good. Um, You know, I was, you know, generally maybe 7 or 8 out of the 12 expirations options work fairly good on everything. This time, I think we're so thin in the breadth. In fact, when you look at the advanced decline line, they're, you know, normally when you're up on a day, you know, it's 3/4 of the stocks are higher, 1/4 or lower. Same thing when you're lower, you know, 3/4 or lower, 1/4 or higher. We've got kind of a market that from day to day to day now seems to be about split. And you can make a case of two things. One, the market's consolidating these things out. Two, that we're seeing at least more selling than we have in previous highs. The problem is we just don't have any volume. No volume up, no volume down. As soon as we try to go down, everybody gets short. We don't have a lot of volume on the upside, but guess what? Those shorts see the market going higher and go, okay, I'll go ahead and cry uncle here and take a small cut instead of a nasty gash. And the market goes just a little higher. So anyway, we're right at exactly where the S&P will close 80% of the time or higher, actually 1 point under on the S&P now. So maybe we don't do much. Maybe we do 20 points. Generally, the S&P loves to hit boundary layers because there are so many people who have puts or calls at a certain level, and 3,400 sounds like a nice round number on the S&P, and we hit those so consistently that it doesn't seem to matter. As we said, volumes continue to be light up and down. Options are tightening and have been for the last few days, but the bias is a little higher. All-time closing highs are were likely in the S&P, probably still going to be up around these levels. But every time we get a sell-off, it doesn't take more than a few hours for at least some part of the market to be bought and bring those indexes back higher. You can give me a call at 877-927-6648, and we'll get to questions and answers. Back on August 12th, S&P was 3340, moving to 3325. You mentioned August 13th, Delta neutral day, Tuesday, Wednesday low, 80% chance of being a bottom with rally into August 21 experience. Well, the odds called the rally. Thanks for sharing. Okay. Yeah, but I do this every month, and every month it kind of is kind of close. About, you know, in about 8 months a year, it'll work very good. Generally, the 4 months that it doesn't work well are when we are in quad witching, and that's just because there's too many other competing factors, like futures and futures on indexes and all the other stuff and bonds and everything else that happens. There's just too many moving parts, I think. But the generally the so next next month, generally options on the overall indexes will be skewed quite a bit and don't work very well. This one pretty much in line to what we were looking at. Anyway, we'll be back in a minute. We'll do a little history. Then we'll move on to some stocks of interest and some prognostics.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And as we do every couple of weeks, we have Tim Ord on from the ord-oracle.com. He's been doing his newsletter for over 30 years. I learned a great deal in my early trading days from him, and those echoes continue to this day. Hear a lot of the stuff that he said early on in interviews on TFNN. Want to welcome Tim Ord again to the microphones of the Power Trading Hour. How you doing today, Tim?
Thank you. Pretty good, Dave. I'm sorry about the charts. I got detoured, and so I got him in late. Hope you get time to have you got him up.
Yeah, and if you think you're crashed, I forgot all about it until they said you were on the line. So we're both having those kind of days where everything is kind of catching up to us. But no, I've already got it up and ready to go and everything. So
all right,
anytime you're ready on those, I think.
All right, this chart one, that's the it's kind of an unusual chart. I play around with a lot of different type things. And what this chart is the is actually Pring. He's been around for years.
Martin.
He got his first name, Mark Pring. Funny how he developed this chart, and what it is it an inflation and deflation ratio, and it's a weekly chart, and it goes back. This looks like about 2000. Oh, it goes back to like 1998. So it's a big time frame. And I did the weekly charts just trying to find something valuable about it. And it's worked over the years really well. And how do I use this chart is when the RSI of the weekly inflation-deflation ratio gets above 70, and that's those dotted lines across the chart. Hopefully you can see them. They're vertical dotted lines. And when the RSI of that ratio on the weekly time frame gets above 70, that's usually never the final high. The final high usually comes when the inflation-deflation weekly ratio gets above the previous high. So in other words, to get the signal going, you have to look at the RSI, the weekly RSI of the inflation-deflation ratio when it gets above 70. That means the market's going to continue higher. You may see a consolidation, which most of the time it did. And then the final signal comes when the inflation ratio gets above the previous high. So back in April of this year, the RSI of the weekly inflation deflation ratio did get above 70. Okay, now you got an ignition. You got ignition of the up move, which it was back in April. The low was March, but you had that big surge off the March low. It kind of peaked in April, had a consolidation for a while. Then now we blasted up to where we are right now. And if you notice, the inflation deflation weekly ratio has to go above the previous highs. I just printed this chart out, and this chart updates after the close. But the last high back in April is 29, and I put down 27 here, but it's actually 26. So what that implies is we haven't seen the final high in the XAU yet, because the weekly inflation deflation ratio hasn't got above the previous high. So it's did I lose everybody on that? So.
No, I think we're tracking it. It's just we probably had a little bit of extra oomph from news and stuff like Buffett getting involved, all that kind of stuff, drove it up a little bit higher. We got kind of a decent pullback, and now we didn't really get any kind of confirmation that that was the last top. Is that kind of what you're saying?
Yeah, we're having that last high we had around, well, on the XAU, I don't know, it looks like about, I'm eyeballing it here, it looks like about, 160 area, a little over 160. So according to this chart, the next high should be above the previous high of the last high on XAU, so somewhere above 160. So, you know, we got a little ways, maybe not a little ways to go. It depends on when the weekly inflation deflation ratio gets above the previous highs is when you have to start looking for a high. We did have, you know, if you remember rallying into that previous high, we did have kind of an exhaustion move where volume kind of exploded. So that kind of halted the market. And we blew down into the August 11th low. And if you looked at volume, that was a selling climax because volume was over 100% compared to the previous days. So what I'm kind of looking for is a test of the August 11th low. And on GDX, that's approximately around 39. So I think that's the next buy area. Then from there, we should head back up again and break above the previous highs, which is around 46, so somewhere above 46. Could be accomplished here, you know, probably, my opinion, probably be in September sometime. So so at least on this run from the March low, what I'm saying is, at least on gold stocks, this XAU, HUI, or GDX, we haven't seen the final highs yet. You know, gold may not make a higher high, maybe goes up, matches it, but the gold stocks probably will. So we've been talking about, you know, the markets and stuff like that, but we never really covered gold much. So this is one of my charts I think is in the coming weeks. I think we'll see some sort of a high before the year's out. And either that high may come in September, maybe October at the latest, but probably sometime before the election, some sort of a high, but not a major high, just a. Because I'm thinking longer term, we really kicked off a major up late. That may last several years because there's a 16-year cycle to gold, and we're on that upswing on that cycle right now. So it'll be interesting to see in the years to come. So,
do you have anything you like to play during election cycles? Gold, silver, is that always a hot commodity this time with a four-year big election cycle, or is it kind of catch as catch come?
It kind of, you know, depends, I guess. You know, they're pumping so much money into, you know, the relief and all this other stuff. These trillions of dollars evidently is having an effect on the market. So, and this, you know, I think the bull market for at least gold started back in 2016. There was a big upswing, and then went kind of dormant, which I'm not really dormant, went sideways more or less. And I think that was wave two down. Then now we're starting kind of like a wave three up. And so when you talk about last several more years,
are you talking about wave, or are you talking about what kind of wave?
Like Elliott wave type stuff.
Okay.
So I'm not really a good expert on it. You know, I picked it up throughout the years, like most probably traders have. But that's how I'm viewing it. You know, this bull market really started in 2016, and now we're kind of in a wave three because we're getting a lot of energy to this rally off the March low, and a lot of stocks have been dormant for years. The little penny stocks are starting to perform again. So that's usually a good sign for longer term.
Okay, we're going to go to the break, and we'll be right back with Tim Ord of the Ord-Oracle.com.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we're back with Tim Ord. You want to go to chart two?
Yeah, let's go to chart two. I'm just throwing this out there just because it's a different. There's a lot of indicators out there, and everybody, you know, all the books kind of cover all the same indicators all the time, and after a while, those indicators become kind of useless. Is what my point is of developing this chart, and. This chart's kind of a little different twist, but the middle chart is a weekly GDX GLE ratio. And the top window is the RSI of that ratio. And it's kind of a, GDX seems to work well with velocity type indicators. And that's what this indicator measures. Measures the velocity of the GDX-GLD ratio. And when the RSI of this weekly ratio gets down below 30, usually at a near midterm low. And this chart goes back to 2006, and it's a weekly chart. And over the last, was six signals, you know, there's one failure, and that was 2018. The market was in a raging bear market at that time, so that signal did not work. It wasn't total disaster, more or less. Did go down, but didn't go down a lot, but did go down. But all the other signals worked pretty well, and the last signal was triggered was at that March low. The GDX-GLD ratio RSI fell below 30, and that was a buy signal, and that was on the weekly time frame. So I just kind of wanted to point it out. And this indicator really works well for bottoms, and it works well for tops, but you don't get that many signals at tops. It called pretty much fairly close at the 2016 top, as the RSI, that ratio did get above 70, and called that top back in 2019 high. Again, it got above 70. And I don't know if this time around the RSI will get above 70, but if it does, that'd be an important signal to pay attention to. Right now, we're kind of just in the middle of nowhere. RSI is coming at 59.63 when I printed this chart. So, but if it does get up to 70, then that'd be a decent sell signal, but don't know if it will. But right now, it gave a buy signal in March, and it still remains on a buy signal. So, and since it's a weekly time frame, it's kind of an intermediate-term time frame. So definitely that signal has worked, as the market has definitely gone much higher. So just an indicator I wanted to share with everybody.
So, okay. I got a question, probably not related to gold here, but we've seen volume really over the last couple of weeks really come down. And it doesn't matter whether the market's going up or going down. The volume's going down. Especially, you know, the previous few months.
Right.
Just a condition of the end of the summer. Do you remember seeing conditions like this where you really had not a lot of volume on the way up or way down of any move that you had from week to week, and each time the volume just keeps getting a little less and less and less? Is that indicative of anything?
Yeah, I was long a couple of days ago, sold out, and so far that's a high close. I don't know what today is going to do, but we're banging against the February high, and volume is kind of pathetic here. And so normally when you break highs, you should see a sign of strength, and really haven't done that. But we're not really backing away from the highs here either. So you got light volume sticking at the highs, more or less, at least so far. You know, McCollum Oscar is below zero. You know, it's not really a bullish sign going on here, but, you know, there's, you know, we really had a pretty big sign of strength off that March low by a lot of indicators. You know, McCollum Oscar went from minus four, or the summation index, and went from minus 400 all the way up to over 1,000, and that's usually intermediate term bullish. You can have corrections, and I thought we might get a 50% correction here, you know, before the year's out of that, of the rally from the March low. And I don't think now that's going to happen. I think the worst case scenario on the SPX is maybe, you know, the previous, at worst, I guess it'd be maybe 3,000, but I don't think we can get down there. I think maybe 3,200. It's about the worst we go. And we did push through that gap, that February gap on light volume, which is usually not a good sign. So I'm thinking we're going to do a whole lot of nothing for the next month or two. You know, seasonality-wise, this is probably worst. Seasonality-wise, this is the worst part of the year from July until October. So I think the upside is minimal, but I don't think the downside is really terrific, you know. 10% at most, you know, probably 5 at least, and that's about it. Then, so I think it's, You know, I think the market's kind of waiting to figure out who's going to be president, I guess. And it's not going to sell off a whole lot. Unless, I guess, it probably would sell off a whole lot if it's Democrats. The only reason why I'm not against Democrats, I'm just saying that because that would be a change of policies compared to what Trump is doing. I'm sure the Democrats would change a lot of things, and the market does not like change at all, and that have a big effect on the market. The way I'm reading it right now, with that really seeing huge danger here, that tells me that Trump, at least so far, is still the elected, maybe getting reelected, just because of the way the market's consuming, especially if the market doesn't pull back and stays relatively firm going into November. That usually indicates that the current president will remain president again. So, but if we do get a big correction, you know, except like 10% or more, then chances are the baton is going to hand off to the other party. So, but getting back to your deal here, I don't see huge danger to the downside. I know the put-call ratio readings are really bearish. But again, momentum rules everything. And momentum so far remains, you know, it's weaker than it was a couple of months ago. But at the moment, it still remains up. And the VIX is, even it's up around 20, I know. It's not really blasting through, you know, 30 or anything, suggesting there's huge danger here. So
what on two things I've been thinking about, since it's sitting up here at highs and it's not really backing off, we're probably going to go higher. Right. So you got two choices. One, we blow through, we get a sign of strength. The second one is we go up, we get nothing, and a blow off top. And maybe that blow off top brings us back down and we get that 5% correction.
Maybe. Well, you know, I think if you're going to have the blow off top, you would have seen that blow off top pushing through that February high. That's where you should have seen, which I was kind of hoping that would happen because it would be pretty obvious, and we didn't get that. So I think the blow off top is off the table because we already, you know, tested that high and nothing really happened. And, you know, we're not really backing off here either. So I'm thinking we go sideways here. I think there's a lot of nothing is how I'm reading it.
Well, good enough. Thanks, Tim, for being on the show. We've got Tim Ord, ord-oracle.com. If you want either of his charts, actually, I'll send you both. Just email me at path@tfnn.com. Thanks again, Tim.
All right. See you in a couple of weeks.
You bet.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we have a question from Hector. It says, GTX this week is pulling back on lighter volume. What are your thoughts on long-term buy and hold? This thing is just in a giant triangle. At least if you go back to, we'll look at it here. What is it? Go back to April 3rd. Well, actually, even back to March 18th, each low was a higher low. But you've got, since June 8th, that high is now a higher high. Again, I would wait until it gets and busts one way or the other and gets a decent move, and then look for the opposite side of that trade. What you would like it to do is come out here, gap down, have volume the first day, kind of go sideways, kind of give it up, and then start moving back higher. So I just don't think right now. It was incredibly hard to find any positions that looked any good. Talking with Tim kind of really drove that home in this last week, and that is there aren't a lot of good risk-reward trades out there. Like I said, not much on the way on the upside. And, of course, if you go long, there's always the surprise to the downside. But every time we go down, someone buys it. So you just kind of continue to stumble higher. I don't see a lot in these stocks that aren't the ones that are Roman candles already. And I see enough sectors that are kind of breaking down. But again, not a lot of momentum, just kind of pulling back and consolidating. So I'm going to say you're going to have a chart that really bowls me over to get me to decide to do anything right now. I've got a couple of option plays that if something spectacular happens, maybe – they pay off, but they are for the most part lottery tickets at the moment, and don't see much else changing that we'd have to have some kind of huge announcement or news that no one knows about that's not in the market, because literally everything in the market that gets brought up gets shot down as far as a bearish downside long-term thing. Maybe it takes us all the way through the election. Hard to tell. But certainly, there isn't a lot in this particular chart. It went away, huh? Unclear on why this thing does that all the time. But it shouldn't. Okay, so that's one. Got a question for the charts. I'll get to those during the break for all those folks. Pam and Tim and is Gerardo. We'll get those out to you. And let's take a look. Question about Apple and why I suspect it continues to go higher, $470.50 today. It's just the day-to-day shorting continues to be basically ridiculous. And as I've said before, the market generally, when everybody gives up shorting, is one of those kind of stock or times when the market can roll over. But here is the most expensive. Well, I don't know if it's the most expensive. It is the highest capped stock in the market. It's got $300 billion of cash. And they shorted it to the tune of one of every three shares yesterday was a short. Now, who knows how many of those people held it till today. But, you know, generally, when you have 5% or 10% of a stock that gets shorted, that's kind of a – used to be kind of a lot. Now, people just pound on stocks all day long, and they just eventually have to cover it, and they go higher. And I've seen markets like this just kind of have a feedback loop of pushing higher. But 33% yesterday of the trades, one out of every three shares was a short yesterday for Apple. I'm not surprised it's going higher. And until people give up, it's probably going to continue to go higher. On a fundamental basis, you've got 5G rolling out. You've got new phones from Apple. You've got carriers like Sprint, Verizon, and T-Mobile that are kicking old phones that do not have the, I think it's called Band 71, system on or off them, off their systems. So people are going to have to get new phones. Question is whether or not they spring for a big expensive iPhone or just another, you know, maybe garden variety smartphone from Android, or maybe an expensive one from Samsung. But the question remains, a lot of these iPhones from the iPhone 6 and 7s, I think even the 8s, don't have that band. I want to say it's band 71. But especially if you don't live in a really congested area, like downtown, you know, top 10 markets, what they've done is turned on that band 71, which used to be the old UHF television stations, to get a lot more bandwidth for them and get the congestion off a lot of the towers and get actually a longer distance per tower. And it's not so much 5G as just making the old towers work as they continue to build out their 5G infrastructure. But by kicking people off with very old phones, it becomes kind of less of an issue, and that band 71 will work. Anyway, a lot of discussion when people are buying new phones to make sure that whatever phone you do have at least gets that band 71, which is that UHF channel. Jimmy ordered the Moto G Power. I actually have the Moto G 7. And actually, dollars for donuts, one of the best phones. I paid it. I have to tell you, I paid $100 for mine, though. And if you want a decent deal on a phone that's cheap, you can actually get it through Google and get a get one of those. I think it's like $140, $150 now. You have to use it for a month, but then you can cancel the service and move it over to your own carrier. So just get it, use it for a month, and then swap the SIMs in it, and you're good to go. To a question about OLN. Let's take a quick look at that. Olin. The only thing I remember is that these guys make a ton of stuff for cleaning your guns. Must make other stuff too. But I just remember, especially as a kid, buying a lot of this stuff. Yeah, we'll talk about this when we come back. I'm sure they make other stuff too. We'll get up and break. Still have a little bit of time to give me a call or an email. 877-927-6648. Email me at path@pfnn.com.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as...
Whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and a Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And I'm trying to find it here. Okay. Quick peek at OLN. Doesn't know whether I'm going long or short or whatever. I assume they're thinking about going long here with this incredibly light volume down at the lows. $10.12 on July 9th with 5.6 million shares. 1.65 million shares now. Very good looking chart. You're right at the previous gap. And like I said, like thought before, chemical products international. I just remember I had a lot of gun cleaning products that I used. Bleaches products, potassium. Apparently, this make all kinds of stuff: coatings, paints, windshield wiper blades, electronics, constructions. Man, if these guys if they don't make it, you probably don't need it. Epoxy segment, acetone, cumene, phenols, other big words. I guess this is probably a play on the economy, but it's a good looking chart. You had that nice long pullback down here and you've had light volume. Dislike the volume yesterday and the couple of days before. That may take a few days to consolidate out, but the whole market right now kind of looking a little congested. And I think we're going to probably have to continue with that consolidation until we sort out how a few of these different sectors are working. Right now, of course, big tech doing everything Apple. If it's being neglected, it seems to be that these stocks are getting the neglected stocks, even with lighter volume, continue to be weaker. So maybe we do need a little bit of a pullback. But right now, not a lot of good risk reward. And I'd have to see this thing probably go sideways on light volume for a couple of days, maybe next Wednesday. Maybe some sign of strength changed my mind. Sell when you can, not when you would have to. And we'll see you here tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time.